The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
With difficulties, beware of measuring your own strength against those challenges. The calculation is certain to riddle you with anxiety without me. You wouldn't make it through the first hurdles. So when we stand there and we try to calculate the things that we're going to do without God in the picture, it's going to be a very difficult walk. But with the Lord, all things are possible. The way to walk through demanding days is to grip my hand tightly and stay close to me. Let your thoughts and words that are spoken be richly flavored with the trust and thankfulness, regardless of the day's problems. I can keep you in perfect peace as you stay close to me on a daily walk. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. This time we're going to go to our song and worship. These are not our songs. We have not written them, but we are thankful for those who have written them and allow us the privilege to sing them and give praise to God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right. Need just a little more on this one here, Wes. There you go. All right. As they're getting things ready to sing our songs, we're just so thankful to be with the Lord today and all the blessings that He gives us. This song tells us sometimes we just can't do those things.
They say sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some.
Say the word, but even if you don't,
Can you say it is well with your soul today?
Amen.
No matter what's
Amen.
Going on in your life.
Amen.
No matter what the devil's throwing at you. Praise God and say it is well with my soul. Amen.
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 Yes.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Don't know what's going on, but our moose is coming up missing.
That's all right.
We can see
how
I found it.
Yeah, that's right. Amen.
Amen.
Inspirational verse I like to share with everybody.
Sure.
Yeah, stand on up.
It comes from Matthew chapter 28, verse 20. It says, teach them to observe all things. Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. Amen.
Amen.
Amen,
amen, brother. That's the truth. Amen.
Amen.
You know, if he is for us,
nobody. Nobody. If God's for us, nobody can go up against God.
You know, it's strange that he makes that statement. Did you get the picture I sent you?
Mm-hmm.
We lost our granddaughter.
You're okay, Wes.
And as we was coming back from the funeral, looked up, and there was a half angel wing looking cloud, and it looked like the sun was up there, and in front of the sun looked like a rainbow that was tattered. And I told Jim, I says, look at, I says, it's not a drop in the sky, but here's a rainbow, and the sun, I looked over to the side, and the sun was over to the side. I don't know what that was shining through that made it look like the sun, but it brought my attention to it. I went to get my camera to take a picture of it, and it was gone. And to me, that was a promise that God had given that to us, that he gives us a promise that he'll take care of us no matter what. And my granddaughter had given her life to the Lord, and I know that. But the world came along and did some things that took her life. And I know it wasn't God's plan. It was the world that we live in. And the other day, Memorial Day actually, Joanne came, which was Jim's sister, and I got a picture of this. And we're talking, and I was telling her about our granddaughter's stone. And on that stone, I did John 10, and it was 28 to 29. That no one can pluck you out of my hand, God's hand, if you give your life to me. No one can do that. And I was telling her about that verse and that I believe in it so strong. And we looked up, and there was a cloud that was fully formed. And it looked like a face. It looked like hair. It had a flowing dress on it. And down at the bottom was a rainbow again, and not a drop of rain in the sky.
Amen.
That is the Lord telling us that he keeps his promise.
Amen.
You
Amen.
Give your life to the Lord, and there is no one, mm-hmm. no one can pluck you out of his hand.
Amen.
There is nothing
Amen.
In this world
no.
that can take you, except you saying, Lord, I don't want you in my life no more. I'm going this way.
Mm-hmm.
And then he cannot do anything because you have told him, go away. But if the world does it, he, nothing. And he shows his signs. He gives his signs that he keeps his promise. So it's amazing you give those scriptures because that is true.
Amen.
That is true scripture.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. We'd never be sorry for praising the Lord. Never.
Yeah.
Amen. Never apologize when God is leading you.
Another prayer verse that I use as well. You'll find it in Philippians 4:13. It it says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me.
Amen. Amen. All right. Thank God for the testimonies. Amen.
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 You are my joy, you are my song, you are the well, the one I'm drawing from. You are my refuge, my whole life long, where else would I go? Surely my God is strength of my soul. Your love defends me, your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me, your love defends me. Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Day after day, night after night, I will remember you're with me in this fight. I know the battles already long ago, is already won. I know the road's already won. Surely my God is strength of my soul. Your love defends me, your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me, your love defends me.
Bless this offering, multiply it, make it useful for your kingdom. We just ask this in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Lord, we thank you for all you do for us, Lord. This time, Pastor Sandy's going to come and bring the message to us. Lord, we just pray an anointing on her, Lord. Let her soul be filled with your spirit, Lord. Let the lips that she speaks be the lips from you, Lord. Just anoint her, this the message she has for us today. Give her many blessings in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Praise the Lord, everybody.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We give you glory, honor, and praise, God. We thank you, Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, God, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Father.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. As I was looking at Saya, as she was praising the Lord, Mary, I thought about that rainbow. Because it was like, as she was praising the Lord, I could see that rainbow, and it was just beautiful. So I thank you, Saya. You did a beautiful job. I give God the glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. You've been so good. You've been so good. You've been so good. You've been so good. I just want to thank you, Lord. You've been my friend. My friend, you've been my friend, you've been my friend. I just want to thank you, Lord. You made a way, you made a way when I didn't see a way. You made a way. You made a way. And I just want to thank. I just want to thank. I just want to thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Turn with me in your Bibles to John chapter 15, verses 4 and 5. Daddy, I need my Bible right here. My Bible. John chapter 15, verse 4 and 5. Hallelujah. John chapter 15, verse 4 and 5. And when you find it, please stand for the reading of God's word. Hallelujah. John chapter 15, verses 4 and 5. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And the word of God says, abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine. Neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Amen. Hallelujah. May God add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, and the doing of his word. You may be seated. Praise God. I know that quite some time ago, God gave me a sermon similar to this. It was the same scripture. But how many know that God's word is fluid? You can read it one day, and he will give you something out of it. And you can go back weeks later and read that same scripture, and you'll see something else in that scripture. And that's what God has shown me today. I know I've preached this passage before, but like I said, God's word is fluid. Hallelujah, and I thank him for his word. This past week has been a little challenging for me. On June the 1st, was going down State Street, turned to go into the bank because I was getting ready to take my car to get an oil change. Turned off of State, East State, into the parking lot of the strip mall, and then the bank was sitting right there, so I was getting ready to park, and bam, somebody hit my car.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
I said, Lord Jesus. I didn't get upset. I just got out the car. And the young man, he was nervous. He was upset too. We exchanged information. You know, I called the police. They said they don't come up in the parking lot area. So I just took pictures and turned it into my insurance. And I thank God because it could have been a situation where the front of my car could have been damaged to the point where it was not drivable. I can drive my car, and today when I leave church, I'll be taking it to the collision place and they'll start working on it. So I thank God. They could have been worse. I could have been injured. He could have been injured, but it was just a little fender bender, and I give God the glory. Then I went on that day, and another personal situation popped up, and I could hear the Lord say, abide in me. It was a situation that could have taken me off of my faith in God. It was a situation, you know, when situations come up with your family, it's hard, and you really, really had a hard time. And I was praying for this particular family member, and I was praying that God would intercede. And I had to go to work, and as I was sitting there in training at work, and it was still on my heart, heavy, and I felt tears running down my face. And I heard the Lord say, thank God they let us out of training early. And I came out of training early, and as I was getting ready to drive out the parking lot, the Lord said, go to the church. And then I came here to the church. Because see, when you go home, if I had went home, I would have got busy with something. I might have prayed, but it wouldn't have been, like I needed to pray. And I would have probably turned the TV on or found something else that I needed to do. But God brought me here. And he brought me here, and I came up here and I sat. And I got me some tissue, and I just cried. I could see these walls. I could say, hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus! I could yell as much as I want to yell. And I don't have to worry about my neighbors knocking on my door. What's wrong? Is anything wrong? I didn't have any problems. And I came in here and I stretched out on the Lord. And let me tell you something. I prayed, hallelujah. And I gave that situation over to God.
Yes.
And as I was praying, I've never experienced this before. As I was praying, I began to see coming through the door family members. I began to see my mother and my son and my grandmother and my great-grandmother and my uncle and my aunt. And it was like they all came and they were surrounding me. And in the middle, it's like I could see the image of Jesus and the Holy Spirit. They were just hugging me. And God said, before this day is over, everything is going to be all right. Just remind yourself to abide in the vine. And that's where this is coming through today. Yeah. We got to abide in the vine. I don't care how bad the situation may look. Jesus will answer your prayers if you give it over to God. If you get in with him and allow him to engulf you, allow him to hold you, allow him to let you know that everything is going to be all right. Every scripture that came through today was right on time when Mary was saying, the Lord said, no one is able to pluck you out of their hands. And I remember I was praying, God, don't let the devil pluck my family out of your hands. I remember saying those words. I remember God saying, everything is going to be all right. And my testimony today, when I got home, 9:30 in the evening, I got the phone call that let me know the situation had been resolved and everything was all right. So I give it to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We've got to learn to abide in the vine. Hallelujah. No matter what it looks like. Hallelujah. Oh, no matter what it may seem, hallelujah, God is with us in every situation. You know the enemy, like I said, he'll try in every way to continue to have us looking through our natural eyes or continue to have us thinking that we can fix a situation. There are some things with a lot of situations we can't fix.
Amen.
We can't change hearts. We can't change minds. But we can abide in the vine and trust God and everything will be all right. Hallelujah, because people will begin to line up to the word of God. And that's what we got to remember. Hallelujah. People will line up to the word of God because his word is going to make situations, circumstances, they're going to change where people, you'll hear them begin to say, hallelujah, my life is changing. Hallelujah. I heard those words from a family member who earlier that day was thinking they had no reason to live. Who earlier that day said they had nothing in life. And then to have them call me back and say, I know that was just the enemy. I'm a child of God. I love the Lord. And I'm going to continue to work and fight this battle until I overcome. Because I know that's what God wants me to do, to be an overcomer. And when I was looking at these scriptures about abiding in the vine, we know that a vine, hallelujah, has many parts to it. You got that vine that comes up, you know, sometimes it grows up alongside of your houses. You can go past houses, you can see where the vines have grown up alongside the houses. If you look down, you'll see that some of the vines are very thick and they're heavy and no matter what you do, you can't pull them up. That's the way we need to be with Jesus. Jesus is our vine and we need to abide in him because he's strong. He can handle all situations. He could take things that we never thought would change and change those things. Hallelujah, right before our very eyes.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit, hallelujah, will guide us and direct us just like that vine is being guided and directed to go up the side of that house. The Holy Spirit, if we rest in him, it was almost like I was sitting here and I found myself just laying out in the hands of the Lord. I said, God, I can't do nothing. It's up to you, Jesus. And I laid out in his arms and I know, hallelujah, God took that situation and he handled it. Hallelujah. In Proverbs 3:5-6, it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not into your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will direct your path. And this is a scripture that God gave me when I first got saved. And I'm going to tell you, the enemy will try to take these very words out of your mouth and out of your mind. Hallelujah. Trust in the Lord. The enemy will bring circumstances around you things that are happening that you don't understand. And I mean detrimental things that you can't seem to fathom why they happen. But God's word said, trust in me. Don't lean to try to figure this out yourself. In all your ways, in everything that you do, hallelujah, hallelujah, acknowledge me. But sometimes that's hard. It's hard sometimes when you're faced with situations that you be saying, Lord, why? Why did this happen to me? Why did this happen to my family? And the Lord will just say, just trust. Yeah. Trust. Trust in me. It's going to work out. It's going to be all right. You got to trust in me. Don't think about, because see, the enemy, the mind is a battlefield of the enemy. And he'll try to get us to try to think on, well, if this hadn't happened, if I hadn't did this, or if I hadn't did that, or if this hadn't come about, maybe situations would have changed. The direction that God wants our lives. I don't care what it is. If the enemy comes in like a flood, God said, I'll set up a standard against it. All we got to do is trust. He said all things. He didn't say a few things. All things work together for the good. For those who love me and are called according to his purpose. Amen. And as I'm standing here thinking, I'm thinking about my son. When God called him home, I couldn't understand it. But God has shown me, even though it's been over 20-some years, God has shown me I wouldn't be where I am today. My daughters wouldn't be where they are. My son wouldn't be where he is. And if we hadn't have stretched out on Jesus and those negative things, God turned them around for his good. If I want to encourage the Geiger family, because I know how difficult it has been. I know, you don't have to tell me, I know it's been difficult. But God is saying, all things work together for the good. Amen. All things work together for the good. Even though you may not have seen the turnaround and the change in Chelsea with your own eyes, trust me, there's been a turnaround, there's been a change. And now we can honor her life and help so many others with her life, with the upcoming ministries that God has placed. He's not allowing her life to go by the wayside. He's using her life to turn other people around, not only in their family, but in the community, in the world. He's using, hallelujah, what the enemy thought he was doing. Hallelujah, to destroy this family. He's using it to encourage it and build it up in the name of Jesus. Amen. He's turning it around. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. He's turning it around for his good in the name of Jesus. And we thank God, hallelujah. We think about the end result. But you know, they don't have to worry anymore about where she is and what's happening, because they know that she's in the arms of the Lord. Amen. They don't have to worry anymore about people trying to destroy her life and strip her of her relationship with God, because they know that she's eternally in the hands of the Lord. And when you know, hallelujah, that your loved one, regardless of what the enemy tried to do, your loved one is in the hands of the Lord, that's something to shout about. That's something to praise God about. You gonna miss him. I still miss my son even after 20 years. I miss him. But you know what? I know that his life meant something. And he has turned other people's lives around. To see, hallelujah, people still coming up to me. Last night I was at an event. These young people, That's April and Shine. That's April and JJ and Shine's mom. I remember Shine. They began to share with me how Shine said what he said and what he did to help them throughout their life. That made me feel good. I was standing there with another friend of mine whose son was shot down on Easter Sunday. Hallelujah. And tears was welling up in her eyes as she was telling me about it. And when she heard these people sharing with me what my son meant to them, she went inside to get some coffee. And she came back, she said, Sandy, hallelujah, there were some people in there that knew my son. And they knew what happened. And they called me by my maiden name, but they were sharing with me, just like you, everybody was sharing with you, they were sharing with me what my son meant to them. That meant so much to her. Hallelujah. It helped to make her day. And as a counselor, she wants to work with us on our turnaround ministry. She wants to deal with grief. She wants to deal with people being incarcerated. Hallelujah. She wants to share how God can keep a parent or keep a loved one, even in the midst of negative situations.
Amen.
So I'm looking forward to her coming to be with us. Hallelujah. Abiding in the vine. I learned something by abiding in God's vine, because it takes the weight off of us. It gives us peace that passes all understanding. People will be looking at us, how can you be smiling? How can you have peace in your heart and mind? How can you be out here encouraging other people? I know what you've been through. I know what you've gone through. How can you be out here sharing the word of God when I know what you've gone through and I know where you've been? But when you abide in the vine, when you abide in Jesus, he'll give you that peace that passes all understanding. Other people might not understand it, but you understand it because you know, hallelujah, even your tears are covered by the blood. Hallelujah. Everything that you're dealing with is covered by the blood. When we abide in the vine, we can be witnesses, living testimonies. Hallelujah. Of what God has done for us and in our lives and in the lives of our loved ones. We can be testimonies. We can show people that no matter what you face, if you abide in him and he abide in you, you can ask him whatever you want and he'll do it for you. So long as you abide in the vine. It's so important. I learned that. I learned also to let go of some things that I found was hindering me, and the Lord showed me this past week. Hallelujah. Sometimes we can hold on to people and we can hold on to things. When God is trying to fix them, when God is trying to work on them, we in the way because we're trying to do it. And he said, get out of my way. Yes. Let me do what I need to do.
Amen.
To change this individual, because I love them just that much. You need to abide in the vine enough to trust me enough to know I don't mean any harm to any of your loved ones or any of your friends. What I'm trying to do is to draw them closer to me. But I can't get to them because you're in the way. We got to step aside.
Amen.
We got to get out the way and let God do what he wants to do. All we can do is abide in the vine. Stay with him.
Amen.
You know, you hear a lot of people say, well, I love the Lord. I'm going to be with him. I love the Lord. But they're weak. They're weak branches. And a vine is strong. And if you look at a vine, there are those branches on there that's real thin and flimsy. And they'll break off like anything. But then you've got those strong branches that'll stay in the vine, that'll go up and they'll intertwine themselves around the major vine. And you can't break it. That's what God wants us to be. He wants us to entwine ourselves and our lives and our families and our friends and our prayers and everything around him. And we can't be broken. We can't be torn away from the Lord. But those flimsy ones, those ones that don't spend any time in prayer, those ones that say they love the Lord, they'll come to church on Sunday and they're doing everything else Monday through Friday, Saturday. They're doing everything that they're not supposed to do. They're talking about people. They're gossiping about people. Those are the vines that when a strong wind or a strong situation come up, they'll break off. But as long as you abide in the vine and you wrap yourself up in the Word, wrap yourself up in the blood of Jesus, wrap yourself up in the Holy Spirit, let Him direct you. God knows there'll be times when we're going to have pain. God knows there's going to be times when we hurt. But if we keep ourselves in the vine, under the blood, being directed by the Holy Spirit, it won't be so hard on us. It won't be hard. We got to remember, and so many people don't want to talk about it, but we got to remember there's a real devil out here that does not want us to live according to God's word. And he'll throw everything at us. He'll throw situations at us that are not as big as we think they are. But our mind get the going. And before you know it, we done blew the situation up bigger than what it should be. But if we abide in the vine, God will work it out. He'll straighten it out. And you'll find that peace that passes all understanding. I encourage you today in God's word to stay close to the Father. Time is winding up. I was some friends of mine sent me, I think I sent it to you, Mary, that sun that looked like it was red, blood red. I think I sent it in Messenger. It was up in Michigan. They saw a sun that was redder than the red in that welcome. It was red, and it had the sun looked like it was on fire. And then it looked like it was falling out of the sky. And people were in awe. My grandson said he saw it. And so many people saw it. I said, you know, God, we see the signs of the end times. But do we take the time to do self-inventory? To make sure, number one, that we're ready. To make sure that if that had been the last day, would we go with you? We got to take self-inventory to make sure that we're living according to God's word. We got to make sure that we line up with His word.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's not to say that you might not make a mistake. But those mistakes, if you give it over to God and you ask for forgiveness, He said, I'm faithful to forgive you and cleanse you of all unrighteousness. So we got to remember, stay with the Lord, no matter what it looks like. Abide in the vine. Let the Holy Spirit direct you and guide you to the right place to go. So when the time comes and He split the eastern sky, we'll be able to go up with Him. We'll be caught up in the air forever to be with the Lord.
Amen.
God bless you all. In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Warm wishes from all of us at Parkview Health for a happy, healthy holiday season.
Kate Wyatt, or Dr. Kate Wyatt, as I'm getting used to, and I'm a first-year internal medicine resident here at Parkview. I'm actually originally from the West Coast, the Pacific Northwest, a little town called Yakima, Washington. I got lucky enough to get accepted to a medical school in my hometown. Medical school, you learn kind of like the base general knowledge, and now being in my residency, I'm just learning everything I wanted to learn. So across the nation, internal medicine residency is 3 years total. Typically what it's going to look like is you'll have residents, senior residents, and then attendings, who are people that have completed their residency and they are specialists in their field. We'll do rounds together where we see patients. Ultimately, they're in charge of patient safety, making sure orders are in, and then our education, making sure that we're learning, putting in everything appropriately, and kind of progressing in our knowledge base. Parkview Internal Medicine Residency actually does what's called a 4+1, meaning we'll do 4 weeks of a rotation, like we'll do 4 weeks of wards. Wards is what we do most, especially during our first year of residency. And that's when the ER, the emergency department, calls and says, we have a patient that's not safe enough to go home, they're sick enough to be admitted. We will go down and admit them and take care of them until they're safe to go home. And then every 5th week, no matter what rotation you did, you're in clinic. As a resident, it's just one-on-one, me and the patient. We'll talk together, we come up with the plan, and then I'll go out, confirm with my attending, talk with the attending, and then either all of us or just me will go in and talk with the patient. And that, for me, is really special because then you really get to feel what it's like to be their doctor. We are all really happy to be here, and we all are excited to learn. We are so grateful for our patients for allowing us to take care of them and then being a part of our educational journey. I have a great group of people around me that I enjoy being around that make going to work really fun. We have the support staff. We are supported. If we don't know something, go and find it. There's a person there that helps us. So just because we're learning doesn't mean you're not going to get top quality care. So what happens after residency depends on what each internist or each third year resident decides they want to do. Some of my co-residents want to continue on and subspecialize further, such as cardiology, GI, or pulmonology. And that's an extra 3 years just about on top of internal medicine residency called a fellowship. Myself personally, I really like hospitalist medicine. And so I'll be able to practice that after my 3 years.
Hey, where's this TV? Letting you know, PSA today. You need to wear seatbelts.
They will be the first ones out the gate.
Wait, Michael.
Do not follow too close because we just had a collision out here just a second ago. That's number one and number two. Number three.
Moses Bay Pet Pete.
There's also no bumper cars, okay? They're not bumper cars. They are go-karts. It's very dangerous when you try to play bumper cars with these. They're not bumper cars, they're go-karts. Okay, that's my PSA for today, people. Go have fun and be safe. Later, guys.
Hi, my name is Evelyn, and I am the one that crashed the go-kart. I am okay. I just have this little goose egg right here. But I am okay. And what happened was that I was turning this way to go into the go around the lap thing one more time, and it let go of it, and it turned all the way around and it crashed into the wall. But I am okay. And be careful when you're riding those go-karts. Okay, bye.
Beginning with the 2018-2019 school year, all LTISD school buses will be equipped with seatbelts. It is important for seatbelts to be worn correctly so that all students are safe while riding the bus. Let's show you how. First, click, then tug, and snug. That's right, just click, tug, and snug. Great job. Make sure to stay buckled in for the entire ride. In an event of a crash, wearing your seatbelt may prevent serious injury and can even save your life. Remember, as soon as you board the bus, make sure to click, tug, and snug. Safety first.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Please subscribe to Wesley TV on YouTube.
God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. And when I think that God his son not sparing.
Well, thank you, Pastor Sandy, for that message today. How true that is, that we need to stay focused on God and stay with him and be in total conversation with him. Let the Spirit of the Lord guide us and direct us in our daily walk. And be encouraged that He is always there for us, no matter what the situation is. Through prayer, we are able to overcome all things. Amen?
Amen.
We have a couple closing songs. These songs are not our songs. We have not written them, but we thank those who allow us to sing them and praise worship to God. Amen.
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 Did you say the disclaimer again?
These songs are not our songs, but we're thankful to those who've written them and allow us to use them to bring praise and glory to God. Amen.
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 It's a new day, darling. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes.
This next song is one called I See the Lord. We didn't write it, but we're preaching that we can sing it. There's a message in that song. It's in Isaiah. He was a man of unclean lips, and the angel came and touched the coals to his lips, and his guilt was gone, and his sins had been forgiven. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. The Lord can do the same for us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Ready?
We're ready.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We are sure. Thank you.
shall I say?
Oh, yes.
Will you answer him? I will go for you. Whatever you want me to do, Lord.
Oh, Lord, whatever it is.
Lord, you want me to go?
Yes, Lord.
And I cry.
Holy. Holy is the Lord. Amen. Yes, Lord. Yes.
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 I cry.
Oh, I cry holy.
Holy is the Lord. This kingdom that shall be the end. And I cry.
And I cry. Jesus' name, amen.
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 then.